Hi, fourth grade book club. All right, I am going to do a little bit more of a recording from Shingling to upload to the classroom. So, where we left off is Charlotte and Summer are having an overnight at Shemaina's house. And so, this chapter is called How We Played Truth or Dare. The day I found out my dad died, Summer said. The three of us were lying in our sleeping bags on the floor in Shemaina's bedroom. The ceiling lights had been turned off, but the red, chilly Christmas lights that were strung all around the room gave the walls a pink glow in the dark. Our pajamas glowed pink, our faces glowed pink. It was the perfect lighting for telling secrets and talking about things you would never talk about in the daylight. We were playing a truth or dare game, and the truth card that Summer had drawn read, "What was the worst day of your life?" And she said, "The day I found out my dad died." My first instinct had been to put the card back and tell her to draw another one, but she didn't seem to mind answering it. I was in Mrs. Bob's class when my mom and grandma came to get me, she continued quietly. I thought they were taking me to the dentist since I'd lost a tooth that morning, but the second we got inside our car, my grandma started to cry. And then mom told me that they just found out that dad had been killed in action. Daddy's in heaven now, she said. And then we all cried and cried in the car. Like these huge, unstoppable tears. She was fidgeting with the zipper of her sleeping bag as she talked, not looking at us. Anyway, that was the worst day. Shemaina shook her head. I can't even imagine what that must be like, she said quietly. Me neither, I said. It's kind of a blur now, actually, Summer answered, still pulling at the zipper. Like, I honestly don't remember his funeral at all. The only thing I remember about that day is this picture book about dinosaurs that I was reading. There was this one illustration of a meteor streaking across the sky over the heads of the Triceratops, and I remember thinking my dad's death was like that. It's like the extinction of the dinosaurs. A meteor hits your heart and changes everything forever. But you're still here. You go on. She finally got the zipper to unstick and pulled it up all the way to close her sleeping bag. But anyway, she said, I remember your dad, I said. Yeah, she said, smiling. He was tall and he had a really deep voice. Summer nodded happily. My mom told me all the moms thought he was so handsome, I said. Summer opened her eyes wide. Aw, she said. We were quiet again for a few seconds. Summer started straightening up the card decks. Okay, so whose turn is it now? She asked. I think it's mine, I answered, flicking the spinner. It landed on truth. So I pulled a card from the truth deck. Oh, this one's so lame, I said, reading aloud. What superpower would you like to have and why? That's fun, said Summer. Well, I'd want to fly, of course, I answered. I could go anywhere I want, zoom around the world, go to all those places Shemaina's lived in. Oh, I think I'd want to be invisible, said Shemaina. I wouldn't, I answered. Why? So I could hear what everyone says about me behind my back and know that everyone thinks I'm such a phony. Oh no, laughed Shemaina. Not this again. I'm teasing, you know. I know, she said, but for the record, no one thinks you're a phony. Thank you. Just a faker. Ha! But you do care too much about what people think of you, she said somewhat seriously. I know, I answered just as seriously. Okay, it's your turn, Shemaina, said Summer. Shemaina flicked the spinner, it pointed to truth. She picked up a card, read it to herself, and groaned. Ugh. If you could go out with any boy in your school, who would it be? She read aloud. She covered her face with her hand. What? I said, wouldn't it be Miles? Shemaina started laughing and shook her head embarrassed. Whoa, Summer and I both said, pointing at her. Who? Shemaina was laughing. It was hard to see in the dim light, but I'm pretty sure she was blushing. If I tell you, you have to tell me your secret crushes, she said. Not fair, I answered. Yes, fair, she said. Fine. Amos, she said, sighing. No way, said Summer, her mouth open wide. Does Ellie know? Of course not, Shemaina. It's just a crush. I wouldn't do anything about it. Besides, he's not into me at all. He really likes Ellie. I thought about that, how just a few months ago, Ellie and I would talk about Jack. Having a boyfriend seemed like such a far-off thing back then. Shemaina looked at me. I think I know who Charlotte's crush is, she said in a sing-songy way. I covered my face. Everybody knows, thanks to Ellie, I said. What about you, Summer? Said Shemaina, poking Summer's hand. Yeah, Summer. What about you? I asked. Summer was smiling, but she shook her head no. Come on, said Shemaina, pulling Summer's pinky. There's got to be someone. Fine, she said. She hesitated. Reed. Reed? Said Shemaina. Who's Reed? He's in Mr. Brown's class with us, I answered. Very quiet, draws sharks. He's not exactly popular, Summer said, but he's really nice, and I think he's very cute. Oh, said Shemaina, of course I know who Reed is, duh, he's totally cute. He is, right, said Summer. You'd make a great couple, said Shemaina. Maybe someday, answered Summer. I don't want to be a couple yet. Is that why you didn't want to go out with Julian? Asked Shemaina. I didn't want to go out with Julian because Julian's a jerk, Summer answered quickly. Oh, I had no idea that Julian wanted to go out with Summer. But you weren't really sick on Halloween, right? Said Shemaina at Savannah's party. Summer shook her head. I wasn't sick. Shemaina nodded. I thought so. Okay, I have a question, I said to Shemaina, but it's not from the cards. Oh, said Shemaina, raising her eyebrows and smiling. Okay. I hesitated. Okay, when you say you're going out with Miles, what does that really mean? Like, what do you do? Charlotte, said Summer, smacking my arm with the back of her hand. Shemaina started laughing. No, I just mean, I said. I know what you mean, said Shemaina, grabbing my fingers. All it means is that Miles meets me at my locker after school every day. And he walks me to the bus stop sometimes. We hold hands. Have you ever kissed him? I asked. Shemaina made a face like she was sucking on a lemon. She wasn't wearing her contacts now, just big tortoise frame glasses, as well as a retainer she was supposed to wear at night. She didn't look at all like the Shemaina Chin we were used to seeing in school. Just once, at the Halloween party. Did you like it? I asked. I don't know, she answered, smiling. It was a little like kissing your arm. Have you done that? Kiss your arms? Summer and I obediently kissed our arms, and then we all started giggling. Oh, Jack, I said, making slurpy noises while I kissed myself on my wrist. Oh, Reed, said Summer, doing the same thing. Oh, Miles, said Shemaina, kissing her wrist. I mean, Amos. We were cracking up. Mia, Shemaina's mom said, knocking on the door. She poked her head in. I don't want the baby to wake up. Can you keep it down a little? Sorry, Mammy, said Shemaina. Good night, girls, she said sweetly. Good night, we whispered. Sorry. Should we go to sleep now, I said softly. No, let's just be much quieter, said Shemaina. Come on, I think it's your turn now, Summer. Truth or dare? I have another question that's not on the card, too, said Summer, pointing to Shemaina for you. Uh-oh, you guys are ganging up on me, laughed Shemaina. We haven't done any dares yet, I pointed out. Okay, this is the dare, said Summer. You have to sit at my lunch table on Monday, and you can't tell anyone why. Okay, that's a good one. All right. Oh, come on, said Shemaina. I can't just ditch my table without saying why. Exactly, answered Summer. So, choose truth. Fine, said Shemaina. So, what's the truth? Summer looked at her. Okay, truth. If Savannah, Ellie, and Gretchen hadn't gone skiing this weekend, would you still have asked Charlotte and me to a sleepover tonight? Shemaina rolled her eyes. Oh, she puffed her cheeks out like a fish. You look like Mrs. Otanabe now, I pointed out. Come on. Truth or dare, Summer pressured her. Okay, fine, Shemaina said finally, hiding her face behind her hand. It's true. I probably wouldn't have. Sorry. She peeked out at us from between her fingers. I was supposed to go skiing with them this weekend, but then I didn't think it was worth my possibly twisting an ankle or something right before the dance. So I canceled at the last minute, and then I invited you guys over. Aha, said Summer, poking Shemaina in the shoulder. I knew it. We were your plan B for this weekend. I started poking her too. I'm sorry, said Shemaina, laughing because we had started tickling her. But it doesn't mean I don't want to hang out with you guys too. And this is something that I'd love to talk about with you guys when we talk, because I do think sometimes when you have a group, you feel pressured that you have to keep doing things for the group, even if sometimes you have other feelings. So I just think that's an interesting thing about friendship that we're seeing in this chapter right now. Have you had any other sleepovers in the last month? Summer asked. We were tickling her a lot at this point. Yes, she giggled. I'm sorry. I didn't invite you to those either. I'm not good at mixing my friend groups, but I'll get better next year. I promise. Do you even like Savannah? I said, giving her one last poke. Shemaina made a face that I realized was a perfect imitation of Savannah's ew expression. Now Summer and I started laughing, said Shemaina, patting the air to remind us to keep quiet. Shh, said Summer. Shh, I said. We all settled down. Okay, I have to admit, Shemaina said quietly, she's been really annoying ever since I started spending time with you guys rehearsing. She was so mad when she wasn't picked for the dance. Probably mad that I got picked instead of her, said Summer. Actually, no, she was mad at Charlotte, Shemaina answered, pointing her thumb at me. I knew it, I said. Shemaina leaned her head on one shoulder. She said, and this is her talking, not me, that you always get the good parts in shows at Beecher Prep because the teachers know you were in TV commercials when you were little, and that you try really hard to always be teacher's pet. What the heck? I said, stupefied. That is the craziest thing I've ever heard. Shemaina shrugged. I'm just telling you what she told me and Ellie. But Ellie knows that's not true, I said. Trust me, answered Shemaina. Ellie never says anything to contradict Savannah. I don't get why she's always hated me, I said, shaking my head. Savannah doesn't hate you, Summer answered, reaching over to take Shemaina's glasses off her face. I think, if anything, she's probably always been a little jealous of you and Ellie being best friends. Really? Why? Summer shrugged. She tried on Shemaina's glasses. Well, you know, you and Ellie tended to be kind of cliquey. I think Savannah probably felt a little left out. This had never, ever occurred to me. I had no idea anyone felt that way. I mean, seriously, no idea. Are you sure? Did other people feel this way? Did you? Summer let the glasses fall to the tip of her nose. Kind of, but I wasn't in any of your classes, so I didn't care. Savannah was in all your classes. Wow, I said, biting the inside of my cheek, which is a nervous habit I have. I wouldn't worry about it, though, said Summer, putting Shemaina's glasses on my face now. It doesn't matter anymore. You look really good in those. Oh, I don't want Savannah to hate me, though, I said. Why do you care so much about what Savannah thinks? Asked Shemaina. Don't you care what she thinks? I asked. Let's face it, you're different when you're around her, too. That's true, said Summer, taking the glasses off my face. She started cleaning them with her pajama top. You're much nicer when you're not with her, I said. Shemaina was twisting her hair with her finger. Everyone's a little mean in middle school, don't you think? No, said Summer, putting the glasses back on Shemaina's face. Not even a little, Ximena answered, raising her right eyebrow. No, Summer repeated, adjusting the glasses so they were straight. No one has to be mean, ever. I like this. Okay. She leaned back to inspect the glasses. Well, that's what you think because you're a saint, teased Ximena. Oh my gosh, if you call me that one more time last summer, tossing her pillow at Ximena. Summer Dawson, you did not just hit me with my favorite 800 fill power European white goose down pillow, did you? Said Ximena, standing up slowly. She picked up her own super fluffy pillow and raised it in the air. Is that a challenge? Summer asked, standing and holding her pillow like a shield. I stood up excitedly, holding my pillow in the air. Pillow fight, I said, a little too loudly because I was excited. Shh, Ximena said, holding her finger over her mouth to remind me to keep it down. Silent pillow fight, I whispered loudly. We spent one long second looking at one another to see who would strike first, and then we started going at it. Ximena brought her pillow down on Summer. Summer struck her from below. I made a long side swipe at Ximena, and then Ximena came up and swung at me from the left. But Summer spun around and struck us both from above. Soon we were smacking each other with more than just pillows, the stuffed animals on Ximena's bed, towels, our rolled up clothes. And despite our trying to be completely silent, or maybe because of it, since there's nothing funnier than trying not to laugh when you want to laugh, it was the single best pillow fight I've ever had in my entire life. The thing that stopped it, or else it might have gone on too long, was the mysterious trumpet blast of a fart that came from one of us. It stopped the three of us in our tracks as we looked at each other, eyes open wide, and started laughing hysterically when no one took credit for it. Anyway, 2 seconds later, Ximena's mom knocked on the door again, still sounding patient, but also obviously a little irritated. It was way past midnight. We promised her we would go to sleep now and we wouldn't make any more noise. We were out of breath from laughing so hard. My stomach actually hurt a little. It took us a while to straighten out our sleeping bags and put the stuffed animals back where they belonged. We folded our clothes and returned the towels to the closet. We smoothed out our pillows and lay down in our sleeping bags and zipped them up. And then we said goodnight to one another, but I couldn't fall asleep. Even though I was sleepy, the night swirled inside me. It was like my eyes were too heavy to keep open, but way too curious to close. I got a case of the giggles, and then Summer and Ximena started giggling. We kept trying to shush one another by cupping our hands over each other's mouths. Finally, once the giggles had passed and it got quiet again, Ximena started softly in the dark. At first, I didn't even realize what she was singing. She was singing so quietly. Then Summer took up the song. Finally, I realized what they were singing and sang. Then we all started whisper singing together. Nobody can do the shingling like I do. Nobody can do the skate like I do. Nobody can do the boogaloo like I do. We were lying on our backs, side by side as we sang, and made our arms and hands dance in sync above our heads, and we sang the whole song from beginning to end as quietly as if we were praying in church. Okay. All right. I'm going to stop there so the recording doesn't get too long, and I'll do the other stuff, the other chapters on another recording. Okay. All right. So I'm going to stop right now.